It's so good to see you. It really is, Christian. And this is such a cruel, cruel disease. It really is, doesn't it? Because it just sort of chips away at people. And it's so, so difficult. But there's things that you want to say that people can do to help themselves.
Yeah, well, this campaign, which is called the One Message Campaign, is really simple. It's just take control and know your choices, which means there are options available to you. And I decided to talk about my uncle because in his day, there were far fewer things that he could do. And I did see him. He was a very successful vet, a brilliant and much-loved vet, trained very highly veterinary surgeon, who had to give all that up because he just couldn't do the surgery anymore. And that must be, you know, as a doctor, I can appreciate how heartbreaking that was. And his options were limited. Today, they're not. There are a lot more. But I hear that there are still patients, almost a fifth of MS patients, still don't attend clinic appointments. And I understand that for fear and just that idea of, I just don't want to know, which I've done myself about things and put things off and avoided things. But actually, this message that there is a lot more that we can do, and it's just not just medications, but it's all the other supporting services that are available to people with MS that will make their lives so much easier.
So how do we get them to do this? How do we get somebody who's maybe suffering and just doesn't want to know?
I think it's just to urge them to say, actually, I completely understand, because I've managed to ignore an appendicitis for a week until it burst and I was in hospital for ages, and let's not talk about that. But I understand the fear of not wanting to know, but actually, the treatments that we have now and all the various services are really effective, but they're only effective if you go and access them and are given them. Your condition will change over time unless you're being regularly assessed. It's only once a year. You know, that sounds too much for a dentist, but I think for MS, that's fine. Right. So, you know, there's really no reason not to go. Be reassessed, see what the situation is, see if changes can be made, and that should only make your life better.
Exactly. If we look at it that way, that it's a positive thing, that you're not going to hear bad news necessarily, you're going to get help. And it might be good news. You never know.
You're not going to have your head drilled by the dentist. You know, nothing. I've got a real thing about dentists at the moment.
I can tell.
But, you know, it's exactly designed to try and make every step of the way better for you. Can you keep working? How can we make that possible? Right. How can we make home life more easy? Yep. How can we make you more comfortable? You know, and as a doctor, I see so many patients shy away from things and shy away from appointments, and I completely understand. But I know that they are not going to do as well unless they do start coming to see
us. No, very much so. And we do live in a place where you do have to take control of your own health, because nobody, you know, back in the day, somebody might have phoned up or even called, you know, like call the midwife and they'd knock on the door. But that's not going to happen.
We don't do that anymore.
No. But so you do have to take control of it yourself, don't you?
You do, and overcome the fear. And there are brilliant people who can help you do just that. If it is just fear and not being able to come to terms with your diagnosis, there are whole ranges of services around to help you do exactly that.
No, exactly, and can help you and mentally as well, which is really good. There's been lots of breakthroughs in the MS, and quite recently they were saying, you know, especially to do with stem cell research. Do you think we'll ever get a cure? Do you think we'll ever be in a, or at least something that will help, really help, slow down the process?
I think we already have things that really help. And I think if you look at, say, something like HIV and the advances over a very short period of time that we've made with HIV, up to the point where now we can make people with HIV no longer infectious, I'm sure the same will follow for all other chronic conditions. Medicine is just, you know, powering forward exponentially like this. It's why I love doing it. Really keeps me on my toes. Every day there's something new to read. So, yes, I do think.
And it's good to hear something positive, because obviously today, you know, junior doctors are on strike and people are getting a bit concerned and they're a bit worried. And you do feel as if, is this actually going to get resolved? You know, this is the problem. It's difficult, isn't it?
The junior doctors one is really tricky. It's kind of sad, isn't it, that it all boils down to Saturday. What is a Saturday is what this whole argument today is about. Is it a normal working day? The junior doctors say, no, it ain't. Jeremy Hunt says, yes, it is. I think there's quite a lot of political spin behind that, because if you can get the junior doctors to say yes it is, that means all the nurses, all the paramedics, right, even the consultants, then all have to follow suit. So junior doctors, it's up to you. Fight this one.